You're back in session. Okay, the next thing on our agenda is Economic Development Incentives Resolution by Commissioner Sutton.
Yes, ma'am. First of all, let me say that this resolution does not stop anything we're doing here locally, have done, or will continue to do if the majority votes. In other words, if the majority wants to still give cash incentives, they are perfectly able to do so as long as no action's taken out of Raleigh, which I am suggesting with this resolution. So I want to make that clear. It will not stop anything that we're doing unless something is stopped at the state level. Years ago, when I first came on our board, I voted for cash incentives. I voted several times for cash incentives. Each time I voted, the rhetoric that you heard, not only from other commissioners, other people involved, myself, was that it was something that we wish we didn't have to do, but everybody else was doing it, and if we were going to stay in the game, that we had to be a part of that game. And I voted, like I say, for incentives. I voted for incentives on a particular deal that I won't mention the name of the company now, but that company is a result of what I think the incentives yielded. They had a satellite operation that they expanded. That satellite operation hired people. Those people were all temporaries. Those people basically worked for just a little bit above minimum wage. Those people had no benefits, period. And temporary status is normally status that somebody has for 60 days until they pass probation and so forth and so on. But that was just part of the game that the company was playing. Nobody was permanent at that company. At that particular satellite, everybody was a temporary, and you could be a temporary for 6 months, 8 months, or a year. And we all know, at least I believe, that's abuse of what we should be trying to obtain here in Alamance County. When I finally decided to vote against cash incentives, and I've done so consistently now for 5 years, and I'm not going to put down anybody that votes for them. Let me say that. I mean, I respect everybody on this board. So I'm not making this personal at all. But this is just something I've had to come to a conclusion on, and I did it 5 years ago, and I haven't changed, haven't blinked on it since. When I decided to go against cash incentives was when I picked up the Greensboro News and Record prior to one of our votes here for cash incentives, and I saw where a contractor or a developer for Walmart in Greensboro was going to try to lobby for cash incentives for Walmart. And I said, I've had it with cash incentives. That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. Did some research and found out that there were some lawsuits out there that were pending where a company, I think in the western part of the state, was suing because he claimed that the county was giving cash incentives to a company that was going to come in and be a competitor of his. And I think that particular company made covers for boats or cars or something like that. And he claimed that, you know, he just thought that was a misuse of tax funds to have a new company come in to be a competitor of his and possibly put him out of business. I don't know whatever happened with that lawsuit. There's been several lawsuits, and all of them have gone down as far as the big ones go, Dale and the one in Winston-Salem where two justices voted against the cash incentives. I think Robert Orr, and if I'm not mistaken, I. Beverly Lake opposed that. I think there were two key justices, definitely Orr was one of them, where they just said cash incentives was a violation of what the intention of the state law was. But anyway, to take it another step, I've seen things go on in the back rooms that these commissioners, I'll say, haven't been privy to because they weren't on the board at the time. But there was a specific incident where, you know, offering cash incentives is like a poker game in a way. And I just think that tax dollars that we're entrusted with shouldn't be played like it's a poker game. One particular incident, and I've reported it several times, but I think it is worthy of mentioning it briefly again, was there was a closed session meeting where X amount of dollars, and I'll give you the figure, $4 million was brought out in the closed session. And I just said in closed session, I'm not going to support giving cash. I'll support infrastructure that other companies can benefit from, other developers and so forth, that the whole community can develop a use for, but not cash. And so they said, well, we'll maybe consider two separate votes, one for the cash, one for the hard infrastructure. And I said, well, I'll support the infrastructure. But after that meeting, it appeared that it was possible that there was another meeting with some other commissioners at the chamber with the county manager and so forth, and more money was put up on the table without the other commissioners, the majority at that time, three others, knowing about it. And I just thought, man, that's terrible. And so when the minutes of that meeting, closed session meeting, when the minutes were produced, and Craig wasn't the county manager at that time, and none of the commissioners, I think, on this board were in that closed session. Bill was on the board, but Bill wasn't in the closed session meeting that night. When the minutes came out, it had the total figure involved. It had the four plus two more, roughly, making it six. And I said, we didn't talk about $6 million in that meeting. And Doug Fincannon, who was on the board at that time and in that closed session, who was no longer on our board when the issue finally surfaced, he said, well, see, Tim's right. He said, it wasn't $6 million. We talked about a lesser figure. Larry Sharp said, I think that figure is high. Dan Engel said he didn't remember. And I said, well, I'm not going to vote for minutes that state that it was $6 million. David Smith, county manager, he said he was adamant about keeping it at that figure, even when he came back with new minutes. So when we voted that night for the minutes, all of a sudden, with all due respect, Dan was remembering enough to go ahead and vote that it was six in closed session, and so did Larry. Mind you, both of them had said, I don't remember, and or sounds a little high. So those are the things, those are Pandora's boxes that get open when you play a game such as what we're playing. I'm not against, when I took my resolution at first and sent it down to Justice Orr, he amended it to where it was state, federal, and state, and local be stopped. And I thought, well, now I'm not really crazy about that. I'm independent, so I'm not going to necessarily go with what he thinks, even though his judicial mind's a lot better than mine. But the bottom line is, I thought, okay, our county's in a tier group. We got three tiers. Economically, we've got a tier that's well off economically. We've got one that's in the middle of the road, and we've got one that's not as well off. We're in the middle. And I'm sitting back thinking, well, if the state wants to help a county in one of those tiers, so be it. I'm not going to be against that. I won't let the state worry about that. I'm worried about what we do with our dollars. So I just feel like it's time to speak out and say I want the state to put us all on the same playing field at the local level to where we don't have to compete with Guilford with our dollars. We don't have to put up the money and try to up their ante and so forth and so on to where we're all on the same playing field. And if the state wants to do something, fine. We say that tax incentives. Now, we've heard the statement before that they're going to pay back the taxes and so forth, and we're only giving them X amount of dollars, and they're going to pay that back with their taxes in about 3 years, 4 years, whatever. First of all, tax abatements in the state of North Carolina are illegal. So if you sit back and say any language, in my opinion, that you're going to give them X amount of dollars that equates what their taxes are over a course of 4 years, if that's not getting around your elbow to try to justify something, that's, I think at that point it becomes a little bit unethical, maybe not illegal, but unethical to call it tax incentives. Because you can't abate their taxes, so how in the world can you pay back what they're going to pay in taxes unless you want to beg the issue a little bit? So I would say to you, to anybody, that you even need to be careful about saying tax incentives. So what I've done is I've aggravated Clyde to death and Craig to death to draft this resolution, and I would like to read it. I know it's lengthy, but it's not that lengthy, and I'll try to speed through it. But that's the history of where I've come from on this issue. Resolution against cash incentives issued or offered by local government agencies for business relocation or expansion. Whereas the state, the North Carolina State Constitution, Article 5, Section 2, Article 1, I guess, state and local taxation states, quote, power of taxation, the power of taxation shall not be exercised in a just and equitable manner, shall be exercised in a just and equitable manner for public purposes only, and shall never be surrendered, suspended, or contracted away. And whereas the practice of tax abatement is illegal in the state of North Carolina, however, the practice of offering industrial cash grants or cash incentives are allowed and regularly practiced at all levels of local, state, and federal governments. And whereas the public purpose is served by general economic development and recruitment of industry, and under the circumstances that exist today, Alamance County believes that to be on an even playing field, that it is compelled to offer cash incentives in order to compete with other counties for industrial recruitment, which causes local governments in our region to be pitted one against one another in a negative competitive system. And whereas Alamance County feels that direct grants to specific selected businesses go beyond the acceptable bounds of public purpose expenditures for economic development, and that the best way to put local governments on a level playing field is to allow each community to market its own identity and infrastructure availability by developing a positive system of business recruitment rather than of how much grant or cash incentives each community is willing to offer. And whereas Alamance County is a desirable place to do business with respect to our location to major transportation routes, central location within the state of North Carolina, excellent school system, low tax rates, abundant water and sewer capacities, pro-business and development climates, and willing labor market desiring reasonable wages. Now be it therefore resolved by the Board of Commissioners of Alamance County the following. Number one, Alamance County hereby would like to request our federal and state and local governments to discontinue the practice of broadly interpreting and applying a law that's in front of you tonight, NCGS 158-7.1. And on that one point, I would like to ask, Clyde, where is it in that law that talks about cash? I see it talking about land, infrastructure, but where is it that it even insinuates cash?
D2, in the arriving at the amount of consideration.
Right.
Taken into account for expected tax revenue.
Okay, where does it say you can give them cash, though?
It talks about source of funding and funds. I don't think it, anywhere in here.
So it would be an interpretation, right? I mean, you could conclude it, possibly.
Yes.
That it's just an interpretation that cash is believed to be part of that. That we should discontinue the practice of broadly interpreting that law as we're speaking in a manner that allows local government to provide cash incentives, tax credits, etc., for business relocation and expansions, which can cause undue pressure on local government entities, and instead develop a more positive system of business recruitment, including but not limited to amending the corporate tax code to provide for lower corporate tax rates based upon the creation of new jobs and new investments made by the corporation. Number two, Alamance County supports economic incentives that are based out of, infrastructure needs that will benefit our county as a whole and encourages our state and federal governments to consider incentives based upon those needs. Number three, notwithstanding the passage of this resolution and until the passage of a state law, now that's the key point here, until the passage of a state law that changes the current incentive laws, the Alamance County Board of Commissioners is not bound from offering or approving nor denying, I think maybe that word could have been in there, local government incentives for industrial development and recruitment. All local government incentive requests shall be presented to the Board of Commissioners and shall be voted on either up or down based upon merit after the required public notice and public hearing. Then lastly, number four, Alamance County hereby encourages all counties and municipalities in North Carolina to pass similar resolutions, as we feel that we should not continually be putting ourselves in negative financial competition with our neighboring counties for jobs and investment. And this 19th day of July 2010. Lastly, I would say that I talked to the County Commissioners Association today, and they told me that there has not been one resolution similar to this, that they thought it could be very, that it could offer some momentum for a movement to start to put us on a even playing field, and it may not. But again, this resolution, and I support it and would like to offer it, is just asking that the state put us all on the same playing field of where we can not, to where we do not have to feel like we've got to compete by putting up millions of dollars trying to offset the next county's bid or next city's bid or whatever. And with that, I'll leave it. Okay. Leave it be.
I got a question for Tim. In fact, I like this way you've written it, Tim. The only question I had was on, you know, as for us to offer infrastructure. What infrastructure would we have to offer?
Well, now, that, of course, is spelled out in the state law. I can't see in the state law where it does say cash. You could interpret it that way. I would say this to you. I had a state senator, and I'll answer your question, but let me preface it by saying I had a state senator, Tony Forrest, and I met for 2 hours one day, talked about four issues, and this was one of them. And he looked at me, and he's a very well-read man. He said he didn't know that that was even legal. I said, yeah, it is, too. And we went. You went in the back and brought out a check from a file, $30-some thousand. He says, news to me. But the state law does allow you to do industrial parks, infrastructure for them. You can set stuff up in a way to where it not only benefits the industry coming in, but another industry that might want to hook up.
Right. I understand that. The only question I had is, what do we as a county offer? Because we don't do infrastructure. We don't have water and sewer, and we don't do roads.
Well, you could do parks, and you could do, you could front a...
maybe put money up front.
Sure.
Okay. I like this because I think it does put us on a much even more of an even playing field with some of the bigger counties like Winston-Salem and Forsyth.
And with all due respect to all the votes that we've had, you know, I would say to you that, you know, we've approved deals for companies that have threatened to leave Burlington and go somewhere else that were already here with a major facility. And it was one of the earlier deals I even voted for. And I don't believe for a moment that company would have left this area.
And you don't know that.
And it's hard to believe that a company would go to Research Triangle Park on another incentives deal that we approved, which I did vote against, and go down there and pay double the tax rate because they can't pick up $250,000 here. And so, you know, I think it's a game, and I'm willing to call their bluff.
I agree with you on it. It is a game, and unfortunately we've had to play it in the past, but we're out of the
But if the state came along and said, you don't have to worry about that anymore, if we're going to try to help Tier 3, Tier 2, Tier 1, so be it. I think we'd all enjoy our jobs a little better, and I think industry would come to those that deserve it on a balanced effort.
That out of the equation as to how much money can we get from the come.
Other comments?
I think it's great, except I would like to see it start on the federal level, because if we did it on the state level, businesses would go to Virginia, South Carolina, Tennessee, and other areas, and skip North Carolina altogether, and that would be my problem with it. But Tim, with all due respect, I think it's a great idea. Can we go after the feds first?
Would be nice, but it's like immigration.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and that's on another resolution. The feds ain't going to do anything. All politics is local. I believe that with all my heart. All politics is local.
There.
And the best politics is local. And it's got to come from us. And if the whole state was on the same page on this deal, I think.
And it may not get legs either, but that's worth a try.
I'm in favor, so I'd like to make a motion and we go ahead and introduce it.
Wait.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'd like to say that I'm in favor of incentives. If it's going to bring jobs to Alamance County, I think it's part of our job to do what we can do to help the jobs that's available to the Alamance County people. I'm going to support this, but I think it's, as long as the field is even and Alamance County can compete with anybody on those
With what we have to offer.
Even.
Well, I can't support it, and I'll tell you why I can't support it. First of all, you gotta have businesses that you gotta have money to use infrastructure, to build infrastructure. If you don't have any money right now, we don't have any money to do that. And the thing about it, I read in the Times News, I think it was this week, that yeah, it is a bad idea. But it is the way, that's the way it is then now. You've got to give an incentive just about to get anybody here. And I think this is a bad economic time for us to start this when Microsoft may be looking at us. And I think it's going to put a black mark on our county. When it goes in the newspaper, it's going to put a black mark on our county that we are not going to ever give another cash incentive. And that's what we want to do. And so, and that's just, I just think right now is not a good time to do this. But I'm on that Piedmont Triad committee in Greensboro with all these million-dollar people, and I feel like a little peon in there. But I just think that it's a bad idea for Alamance County at this time to try to do this, because it's going to put a black mark on us. And the companies that might would have come will say they don't give us any cash incentive, we're not coming, because it is a way of life right now. And that's my opinion. And no offense to Mr. Sutton, I think it's a good idea. But I just don't think it's the right thing for Alamance County to stick our neck out first on this thing as bad as we need jobs. And if Microsoft was looking at us and they saw this, then we know. Who is it? Winston-Salem. It's got how many $1 million, and I don't know that number.
Not more than we do.
They're competing with two other counties to get Caterpillar there, and it's going to be based on incentives. I promise you that. So I just think this is a wrong time to do this. Maybe in a later time when the economics are better, and you know, I agree. You know, it is a good idea, Mr. Sutton. I really think it's a good idea, but I don't think it's the right thing for Alamance County at this point.
Do you realize that the resolution is saying that we don't stop until the state stops?
I know what the resolution says, but that's not going to be in the newspaper.
It can be.
It better be.
That's not going to be in the newspaper.
We haven't quit doing it since.
Because it's happened time and time again.
We would like to change the playing, the rules of the game.
Time and time again. It's just like Microsoft. Who knows who let that out? We didn't even know it. But I've had calls from Mecklenburg County, counties I never even heard of, about Microsoft. Is Microsoft coming? Cleveland County, you know, all these counties. And Microsoft wants money. Evidently, they want money.
So is it Microsoft?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I still don't know. You're the one that said it was Microsoft.
Thomas said.
My sources have not told me anything, but I'm reading your paper and all the other papers saying it's Microsoft, okay? So, no. Ours was called what? Deacon. Ours was called Deacon, and that's all we knew was Project Deacon. So, anyway, so that's my feelings on it. Okay. Now, Mr. Sutton, if Ms. Vaughn is through.
I would say to you, and I think it's more of a snowballing effort going on than you realize. In Raleigh, they just had the July the 10th vote on incentives there, that broad-based incentives bill. The vote was 72 to 31. Of the 31, 27 were Republicans that voted no. The minority leader out of Wake County in Raleigh, Skip Stan, he's the Republican, highest Republican in the House. He stated that it was corporate welfare, and he said, you know, it's time to really just for people to finally speak out and say what they had to say about it. And again, it was 27 Republicans opposed. I think there's a snowballing effort around to do something about it, and it's got to start somewhere. And I'm proud to try to start it here. Okay. And
I appreciate your effort, but I just got my own opinion, too. So now you want to make your vote?
I'd like to make a motion that we approve this resolution.
Okay. Have a motion on the floor.
Second.
And a second. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? No.
Now, point of order on the resolutions passed like this, where do they go from here?
we will send this to the board commissioners. What we usually do, we get from the clerk's list, you know, that we will send it out to on the clerk's listserv, and that'll get to all the clerks, you know, the county municipal clerks across the state. But we'll also send it to our local legislative delegation, but we'll also send it to
the people as well.
We will.
Okay.
And actually, I talked to Dan Engel Friday, and he said he would move it forward if needed.
Yeah, Dan opposed to this last incentive to doing being in Raleigh.
Okay. Next thing is order of tax collection, Charlie York.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen of the board. As tax administrator, I'm here this evening to receive your order of tax collections. Also, I'd like to report to you that our collections are moving forward. We're 0.53% ahead of last year's collections. I think our office is moving forward. I think the public is satisfied with what we're doing now, and I think our public relations are much better. Our reporting is much better. And at the next commissioner's meeting, we'll have the annual settlement report plus some other reports that I think will be helpful to you.
Okay, is anybody? I don't think we have to do anything.
You had a motion to approve this.
Okay. Before we approve this, I want to thank you for all your efforts down there, because I know you've put in many hours since your predecessor resigned. So I just want to thank you for that.
No, thank you. I want to say again that I'm an Alamance County native, and I love this county, and I want to do what's right for the county. And as long as I'm there, you can be assured that it will be run in an honest manner. I may make mistakes, but I'll never do anything dishonest, and I'll serve the citizens as best I can. We've got a great staff, and we're receiving more training. The Durham County Assessor's coming tomorrow to help us with our one tax training. Our folks were not properly trained when we bought that software, and hopefully tomorrow we'll get on the road to getting better training for that.
We appreciate what you're doing.
Thank you. Do I hear a motion we accept?
No,
this?
No.
Oh,
no.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
You didn't hear me. That's okay.
I'm sorry.
Okay, we're talking about taxes that haven't been paid on vehicles.
All taxes.
Well, I'm just concerned about vehicles right now. I think it was $250 and back taxes and multiple vehicles and so forth that they would have, I think, 72 hours to catch up.
Yes, and we're going to discuss that at the next commissioner's meeting. Oh, okay. We'll have a comprehensive report for you.
Okay, because yeah. I had concern today about, you know, cost to Pat to go get her car, how much is it going to cost? Because
it's towed
away,
Pat, you better pay your taxes.
Okay, I appreciate that. Okay, I'm fine.
Okay, do I hear a motion we accept the order of tax collection?
So moved.
Second.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. No. Okay, thank you, Gerald. Okay, the next is county manager reports.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Let me also reiterate the work that Gerald's done and the working relationship between our departments, and I do appreciate Gerald and his department and all he's done as well. So I do appreciate y'all saying that. First thing on the list is you have in your agenda packet a resolution that will call for a public hearing on the proposed funding for the Career and Tech Building. As the board's aware, we're asking to set a public hearing for the financing for the Career and Tech Building. Currently has a budget of $8.3 million, and that public hearing will be held on August 2nd, 2010 at 7 p.m. Again, the funding that we're looking at is coming from the Qualified School Construction Bonds, which are part of the Reinvestment and Recovery Act, with an effective interest rate right now between 0% and 0.3%. And we're looking at, you know, that will depend on when the bonds are sold, but we're looking at a period of 15 years on that.
3.3%?
It's part of the America's Reinvestment and Recovery Act, the Qualified School Construction Bonds. Basically, the federal government's taking care of the interest.
Any questions?
No.
So I hear a motion that
I'll make a motion.
Public hearing August 7th, 2010. Got a motion in a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Madam Chair, I do want to mention one thing. Publicly, we've talked about in the past about when we were looking at moving passport services over to the Register of Deeds. As the board's aware, we got notification from the federal government that you could not have passports be dealing with the same places where birth certificates are done. So we had to find another place for passport services. We basically moved them a door down to our inspections department, and that has worked out really well so far. So I do appreciate the work that Phyllis Green and also Bob Strobage did in making sure that we had a very easy transformation on that. So I just wanted to mention that for public information.
Why do they mail you a birth certificate when you do a passport? My son got a passport, and he had a birth certificate at his courthouse.
Not sure.
And they mailed him another one for some reason.
Yeah, not sure.
About me.
Ms. Vaughn has a question.
Yeah, for Craig on the retirement.
Mm-hmm.
What have we done about that? How have we done?
We're in the process of, Sherry was on vacation last week, so we're in the process of trying to get the personnel committee meeting and going over the early retirement. Then once we do that, we'll bring it back to the board.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that brings us to the consent agenda. And does anybody want to pull anything?
Well,
go ahead, Ann. I know you got one.
Well,
Ms. Vaughn got something, I'm sure.
Pull E and F out.
Okay, E and F.
E is resolution in support of Arizona Senate Bill 1070. Asking to pull that out because there is, I believe, 7 cases right now. 1 case has already been heard in court. Nothing has been decided on that. And I'm just saying that because I don't know that we're jumping the gun on this resolution. I'll put it back in there and I'll say I support the resolution, but there no court cases have been decided, and that's why I was concerned. Why do we have a resolution in here now when it hasn't been decided in any court? So that just a comment on it.
Okay.
Okay. Or concern.
Any questions from anybody?
Well, North Carolina had more backbone. They would have introduced a similar law, and they didn't do it. And North Carolina, Virginia did it, South Carolina did it, a bunch of Southeast states did it, and North Carolina just has so many liberals down there, they just weren't going to do it. And you know what party they're in. And
okay.
And then F, that's right. He just likes doing that. F, a resolution opposing federally mandated collective bargaining. My comment there is, and that's all it is I think we should have states' rights, and I don't think the federal government should tell us what we can and can't do as far as collective bargaining. We got any firefighters here?
Hadn't this already passed in D.C.?
This has passed the House, but it's not passed the Senate.
Yeah, I read that in the paper this week, that it had passed the House. Any more questions on that? Can we put that back?
Yeah, we can put both of those back.
Okay. All right. Anybody else got anything? Or do I hear a motion? We accept the consent agenda.
No.
Oh, you got something else?
Yeah. The consent agenda I had and the consent agenda that was on the internet are 2 different things. So I really want to know what consent agenda you would like to pass. The discrepancy is on A, 9A, you have appointments, and those are listed 1 through 4.
Right.
Then you have B, voting delegate.
That's me.
Yeah, that's you. We didn't pull that one out.
Go ahead.
And then on C, on the internet, sole source purchase of sheriff's office vehicles.
That may have been removed. There was a issue. We had a concern with purchasing, but it was on state contract. It was some drug forfeiture money that we told the board about.
Yeah.
We did sole source some vehicle purchase, but it was state contract. So since it was state contract, we did not have to come back and ask for sole source approve.
Okay, so we're going to go with the one that was in the packet.
Yes, ma'am.
And not the one that was on the internet. So
yes,
I just want to be
yes,
sure.
Yes, ma'am. The change on the internet was a last-minute change that I made.
Thank you so much.
I apologize.
Yeah.
We make a motion to approve the one
yes,
that we
sir.
Have in our
yeah, and we
you
second
You can make
it.
A motion to approve that one.
And a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, the next thing is commissioner's comments. I have one if nobody. I want to read a letter that I got from a Mr. Shields P. Blankenship of 843 Chester Road, Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And I talked with Craig about this. And it's actually sent to Sheriff Johnson with the copy to me. Said, I recently read in the Winston-Salem Journal that the Sheriff's Department of Alamance County was being investigated by the ACLU and the Civil Rights Division of the U.S. Justice Department because of accusations of racial profiling aimed at Latinos. Congratulations on doing your job properly. It's comforting to know that there is at least one law enforcement agency in North Carolina that is willing to arrest individuals who are residing illegally in the United States of America. Keep up your good work. Sincerely, S.P. Blankenship, Jr. And I thought Tim would really like this letter.
I'd like to recommend our county manager send that guy a letter.
Me too.
Tell him thanks.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
Well, that's fine. I will give him this letter. There you go.
Tell him vote Republican.
Now, wait a minute. So, any more commissioners' comments? Any announcements? I will be going to the state convention for, I'm going to ask.
We're glad you're going.
County commission.
As the delegate, I'm the voting delegate and for the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners. I don't have a place to stay this year like I did last year. That was free.
Ooh.
But I am not staying in the recommended hotel. I'm staying in a cheaper one. So... only because it was full. Now, I shouldn't have told you. But anyway.
Wait long enough, it happens.
But I do appreciate this to be able to go to that. It is very informative. And because I'm there with all of the other county commissioners from other counties. So I really appreciate doing that. And I really enjoy going in and listening to them talk too. So
we appreciate you going.
Well, thank you. Any other announcements? If not, guess what? We're done.
Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioner's website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 2-7253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.